VeganGal.com, and this video is going to be all about Vida Vegan Con in Portland, Oregon, 2013. It will henceforth be known as, referred to as VVC. That's like what all the cool kids say. What is VVC? Well, that was a vegan bloggers conference. This is the second one that's happened, and they're planning to have it annually. This was my first time. In this video, I'm gonna talk about my experience, what I saw, what I ate, what I did, what I learned. So if you attended this conference, you may see yourself in the following videos and maybe some photos in here. And if you didn't attend it, this will be a great opportunity to see what it's like, to see if you wanna go some point. VVC was an amazing place for people that were blogging for a while, just started blogging, or are interested in blogging. We all came together to go to a bunch of different panels, seminars, workshops, whatever you want to call them, all about the art of blogging, specifically in the vegan realm. There was everything from photography to monetization to starting a cookbook based on your blogs, reviewing things, reviewing restaurants and products. There was a lot of great information from experienced bloggers here, and it was just a really informative setting. But one thing that people love most about VVC is that it's an amazing time to network, to meet new people, and that was really my favorite part of it. I met people that I've known online for years and never met in person. I've caught up with some old friends there, got to check out some new things that are happening with the businesses that had vendor booths there, and we also had a lot of fun. You know, I got to know Portland in a whole new way. I'd only been once before. You can check out the video right here to see my old experiences, which were quite different than this time. And I honestly developed a whole new appreciation for Portland through going to VVC. One thing was is that when the first VVC happened in 2011, it also happened in Portland, and I didn't get to go, and I was incredibly disappointed, and part of me just didn't want to know anything about it. I wanted to ignore it. I was just envious and mad that I wasn't there. But I quickly got over it and decided that I was going to check out all of the videos, all the photos, all the tweets and the Facebook posts and the blog posts about it, because I wanted to know what it was like to experience it. And it turned out to be a great thing. I ended up writing all this blog coverage of my own based on what other people were doing. So if you're watching right now and you're feeling that way about VVC, I still want you to watch this and experience it. Don't be envious. What you can do here is learn about all of the amazing things that we took in as attendees. And maybe if this is something that you love, you can start saving up for it and planning for it next year or whenever it happens next. So I just wanted to put that out there because I know how you feel. So let's begin. Portland, of course, is a really fun place to visit. It's really interesting, a very small city vibe, really beautiful, very artsy. I just felt really at peace there. Even though it rained a good chunk of the time, I didn't really mind it. The weather was fairly nice. All you needed was a nice sweater. I got to stay at a beautiful hotel called the Paramount, and the service there was excellent. One thing that I really loved is riding the transportation there. I took something called the Max, and it was super efficient. It was only $2.50 to get all the way from the airport, and ran on time. VVC was held at the Portland Art Museum, which is really, really pretty. It was a little confusing at first because nobody really knew where they were going because the seminars were in different rooms, but kept us going. It was good to work off all the extra calories that we consumed from all the amazing products there. Speaking of which, you name it, all these big companies were there. Tofurky, Upton's Naturals with their great seitan, Go Veggie. They have some really nice cream cheeses and non-dairy shreds and things like that. Bob's Red Mill. Air One has some great organic and gluten-free cereals. Wayfair. Wayfair has one of my favorite products. It's a spreadable cheese. Their smoky cheddar cheese is incredible. You can use it in all sorts of dishes, crackers, grilled cheese, pasta. They also have a new ice cream that's oat-based, so it's soy-free and gluten-free. Also, one of my favorite kale chip companies was there. They are insanely, insanely delicious. Some of them are made with hazelnuts. Heidi Ho, speaking of more cheeses there, they have some block cheeses. They also had a nacho cheese that was so delicious. Peanut Butter & Co. They have some really great peanut butters there, some that are made with chocolate. They gave me a jar to take home, and unfortunately, the TSA took it away from me. Who knew that you couldn't take peanut butter on the airplane? I did not, so good lesson to learn. Missionary Chocolates. They make handcrafted vegan truffles. Really delicious. I only had a few bites of them. They have lots of great flavors. I think the one I had like lemon in it or something. Very, very flavorful. Of course, So Delicious, one of my favorite brands out there. They make incredible dairy-free milks. A lot of them are coconut-based. Amazing coconut-based ice creams, one that is no sugar added, which I love. Compassion Couture, they make lots of handbags and shoes, so people were excited to check those out. Vegan Cuts, love them, of course. They've got their great snack box, and they also have their online store. They're always doing lots of innovative things to make it easy to be vegan. Coconut Bliss, another great ice cream company out there making it from coconuts. Portland Juice Press, can't get enough of cold pressed juice. These were delicious. Pacific, they make some really good non-dairy beverages and soups. Teas and Dandies, which is the same company. They have their delicious vegan marshmallows and their cheese alternative there. They were serving their nachos and they also made s'mores. As you can see, there was a really great group of people. Lots of women, some men, people of all ages. It was just a really great eclectic group. As I mentioned, people from all over the place. Then there were all the great classes. There was one all about parenting, which I love, raising vegan children, monetizing your blogs, how to do advertising, affiliates. Lots of panels about writing your own cookbook. A really nice panel about how to do reviews of products and cookbooks and restaurants and all of that. Really, really informative. Some of the more interesting topics I found were around being sensitive to readers and making sure that you're using the right words to describe whatever's going on there so that you don't really hurt anyone's feelings or say something that someone would find offensive. So just running the whole gamut here of topics and just a lot of great information. I'm actually going to do separate videos to cover these different topics just so that you can learn how to incorporate this into your own writing and videos. And then of course, more food! Veggie Grill sponsored a delicious tasting of some of their best dishes, including their kale salad and some of their chickeny dishes and their wraps. Nachos was there with their delicious nacho sauce. Lily's, one of my favorite hummuses. Oh my gosh, so good on sandwiches, especially their roasted jalapeno hummus. So good. They had tons of gluten-free options, all these different types of delicious faux deli meats to try. Even some raw food options. Their raw walnut meat was good. The Better Bean Company was there. They make delicious bean dips and beans in all types of forms. The lines were a little long, but it was definitely worth it. You would get a great fill of lots of food no matter what your diet was. And of course, you had to make sure to save room for some ice cream because they had a few little ice cream socials. We had a really fun outing one night. Everybody could gather at the Vegan Mini Mall in Portland, very famous place. We have the vegan grocery store Food Fight, the vegan bake shop, which also had some gluten-free items, and the herbivore clothing shop, where they were featuring some s'mores by Dandies. Food Fight was offering up some delicious Mexican taco-like something. I don't even know what those were called, but they were awfully delicious. And I got a huge kick of this t-shirt. They had a few events each day. One of them was a really neat game show type thing where people were called up on the stage and asked trivia questions around veganism and vegan blogging and authors and all that. It was really fun to just get to know everything and learn a few facts. My favorite event was the Gallerama and silent auction for the Chimpanzee Sanctuary Northwest. It was so, so fun. It was held at a place called Staver Locomotive, which had a really neat vibe. So Delicious sponsored it with a great Sunday bar, and there was also incredible cheeses from Miyoko, and she is the authority on vegan cheeses. There was also some really great popcorn that I thought was really interesting. It was masala pop. It was all Indian-inspired popcorn. My favorite was the chai masala. Wow! You have to get your hands on that at some point. I really enjoyed having a chance to chat with people there and have fun. And it was cool seeing all the different silent auction bids. You can get anything from books to paintings to odds and ends to food to lifestyle products, you name it. Lots of cool things were there, and all of the money went to benefit the Chimpanzee Sanctuary. There was also a great photo booth. That was really fun. I enjoyed getting my pictures taken with Christy Morgan and Heather from Healthy Living Starts Here, another one of my favorite bloggers, vloggers out there. But definitely the highlight of the night was the dancing. Started off a little slow at first. Melissa, who did an amazing job DJing, suddenly hit a track that inspired a certain someone to dance. So I'm going to let you just enjoy this part without saying anything. VVC was over before we knew it, and it was time to say goodbye and leave Portland regrettingly. So fast. Well, I hope you enjoyed that little roundup of VVC to give you a little bit of taste of what it's like, and I hope that you go to the next one. It's definitely a blast. I'm going to be making a blog post about this with links to some of my favorite bloggers that I met out there so you can learn more information. I encourage you to support them, comment on them. Follow them, check it all out. It's a great way to learn about how to expand your vegan lifestyle to be the best that it can be. Before I wrap this video up, I want to give a huge, huge shout out to Growing Naturals. They sponsored me to go to this event, and I couldn't have been there without them, but that's not why I love them. I have loved their products for a long time. They make a few great things that I highly recommend. This organic rice drink plus protein in velvet tea chocolate flavor is unbelievable. I drank this throughout VVC and it kept me satiated. I don't know what I would have done without this. I probably would have been very, very hungry in between meals. Mix this in with your favorite non-dairy milk. It is amazing. I had it with the unsweetened vanilla So Delicious coconut milk and it was mind-blowing. It was like drinking a chocolate milk out of this world taste. Wow, it was so good. This is my go-to thing, you can tell because it's empty, almost empty. This is their organic raw rice protein chocolate flavor. Mix this into water and you've got a delicious, amazingly nutritious drink that you can have at any time of day. Both of these products are just great for when you're working out a lot, when you're exercising, when you're on the go. Whatever it may be, maybe you just want to have a nice little drink. This actually replaces 6 boxes of your average size, you know, Tetra Pak non-dairy milk products out there. So it actually saves containers and saves space, and it saves, you know, the trucks that are delivering it. They have to deliver a lot less if you just make your own rice drink. And it's probably more economical as a result. And then they have their Simply Soap Berries product. These are amazing laundry detergents. They're made from this special little berry, this magical berry. There's actually 128 loads in here, so it is super, super concentrated. And you can use it in high efficiency, it's non-GMO, it's hyperallergenic, it's biodegradable, really nice stuff. So you have to actually use a lot less bottles of detergent because this is so concentrated, which thus makes it eco-friendly and non-toxic at the same time. So thank you, Growing Naturals, for helping me go to VVC and for making amazing products that I love. Hope you guys will check these out as well to thank them and support them and keep them going. Thank you so much for watching. I hope that you learned something. I would love to hear your feedback if you were an attendee. What did you think of the event? Who was the best person that you met or the best thing that you learned? Or you don't even have to say best. You don't have to limit it. just tell me all of your favorite things that happened. And for those of you who didn't get to attend, what are you looking forward to? What did you learn from this video or other bloggers out there? What was one of your favorite blog posts or tweets or Instagrams from the event? And are you planning on going next time? Did this inspire you to start your own blog, or do you simply just want to learn more about veganism from all the people out there passionately writing and videoing all about it? Thanks so much for watching. As always, you can find more at my blog/website, ecovegangal.com, and of course you can follow me on all the social media networks where I'm always chatting about things like this. If you like this video, give it a big fat thumbs up, and please hit the subscribe button so you're the first to know when I have more videos like this. Stay tuned, and I will see you later. Bye!